Okay, next up.
Coughing competition.
It's time for competitive coughing.
What is going on?
Well, I've made these cutouts that look just like you and me.
They don't look anything like me.
I always like being in the lab.
It's very hard work. It's a very big team. Spend a long time putting everything together and getting it ready. And then we work for, you know, 10, 12 hours solidly every day. And the main difficulty is Xand arguing.
Well, you can't argue on your own.
But you argue with me. Well, you start it.
Yeah, no, I mean...
They're all blue. I'm the green twit. Everything I wear is green. It's greenish.
Oh, tuck your string in, man. Look at that. I haven't tucked in my little string.
You haven't brushed your hair or so, do you call it?
You're looking quite
wild.
A total scruff pot.
OK, Chris, you ready? 3, 2, 1, cough.
We're doing two experiments, one where the plates are 10 centimetres away and another where they're 50 centimetres away.
This was really funny doing this because you would never cough in someone's face.
Well, all done. Not quite, Chris. I want you to take this agar plate and hold it in front of your face and I'm going to cough on it. And this time, I'm going to cover my mouth with my elbow the way you're supposed to and hopefully no germs should land on the plate. OK, we'll just make sure you do it properly. And now we have to wait.
In lab conditions, bacteria take some time to grow. Luckily, we came prepared.
I'll fall asleep anywhere.
And when we film a little wait, you know, time passing, and sometimes Xand
has
to sleep.
Don't say this. Don't say this.
Xand always, always falls asleep. Xand has never not fallen asleep. When he's like pretend falling asleep. It's never not happened.
The closest you could get to meeting me without meeting me is watching Operation Ouch. It's just, and everyone thinks, oh, what a funny guy pretending to be asleep. A good running joke. No, that's just me. That's who I am. I'm going to fall asleep right now.
Yeah, he
100% sound asleep there.
Finally, the test results are in.
So let's check out the cutouts that were 50 centimetres away first.
Oh, yuck! This has worked really well. All these bacteria have grown into thick...
These are very sort of juicy, and getting those shots takes a long time. So that's all lens change, lighting, really trying to show you the detail. Obviously, you can't see individual bacteria, you're seeing clusters of millions of bacteria. But to show you the detail up close, actually takes a huge amount of time. To get the shots of the bacteria will have taken, you know, the better part of an hour.
Probably. And we also have to be safe with them. I mean, they're real bacteria. They can make you sick.
There's a huge bacterial splat in the middle of the plate. I must have coughed off a lot of saliva with that one. So this is like coughing into someone's face when they're right next to you. And that's bad news for them when you realise that the average cough has 20,000 viruses in it.
Which brings me to our last result. Let's have a look at the plate where I covered my mouth and coughed at Chris.
Oh, two bacteria.
When we filmed that, it would have been sort of 20 years earlier that we were kids, and we were never taught to cough in our elbows. Do you know what I mean?
Probably was 20 years, wasn't it? Now it's 30 years, yeah.
I guess it is a long time ago now.
We've shown that not only could your cough reach the person right next to you, but it could travel a lot further than that.
When I watch that now, even for me, it changed my behaviour a bit.
And it also, I think it's funny watching it now after the pandemic, how much more relevant that feels now.
And as well as seeing how far they travel, we've shown you just how much bacteria there can be in coughs.
Well, there's a lot more in yours than in mine, Chris. You should see a doctor.
Maybe I should. Better go find one.